M. Abstract machines, diagram and phylum. There is no abstract machine or machines in the sense of a Platonic idea, transcendent, universal, eternal. Abstract machines operate within concrete assemblages. They are defined by the fourth aspect of assemblages, in other words, the cutting edges of decoding and deterritorialization. They draw these cutting edges. Therefore, they make the territorial assemblage open onto something else, assemblages of another type, the molecular, the cosmic. They constitute becomings. Thus, they are always singular and immanent. Contrary to the strata and the assemblages considered under their other aspects, abstract machines know nothing of forms and substances. This is what makes them abstract and also defines the concept of the machine in the strict sense. They surpass any kind of mechanics. They are opposed to the abstract in the ordinary sense. Abstract machines consist of unformed matters and non-formal functions. Every abstract machine is a consolidated aggregate of matters, functions, phylum, and diagram. This is evident on a technological plane. Such a plane is not made up simply of formed substances, aluminum, plastic, electric wire, etc., or organizing forms, program, prototypes, etc., but of a composite of unformed matters exhibiting only degrees of intensity, resistance, conductivity, heating, stretching, speed or delay, induction, transduction, and diagrammatic functions exhibiting only differential equations, or more generally, tensors. Of course, within the dimensions of the assemblage, the abstract machine or machines is effectuated in forms and substances in varying states of freedom. But the abstract machine must first have composed itself and have simultaneously composed a plane of consistency. Abstract, singular, and creative, here and now, real yet non-concrete, actual yet non-effectuated. That is why abstract machines are dated and named. The Einstein abstract machine, the Webern abstract machine, but also the Galileo, the Bach or the Beethoven, etc. Not that they refer to people or to effectuating moments. On the contrary, it is the names and dates that refer to the singularities of the machines and to what they effectuate. But if abstract machines know nothing of form and substance, what happens to the other determination of strata, or even of assemblages, content and expression? In a certain sense, it could be said that this distinction is also irrelevant to the abstract machine, precisely because it no longer has the forms and substances the distinction requires. The plane of consistency is a plane of continuous variation. Each abstract machine can be considered a plateau of variation that places variables of content and expression in continuity. Content and expression thus attain their highest level of relativity, becoming functives of one and the same function, or materials of a single matter. But in another sense, it could be said that the distinction subsists and is even recreated on the level of traits. There are traits of content, unformed matters or intensities, and traits of expression, non-formal functions or tensors. Here the distinction has become entirely displaced, or even a different distinction, since it now concerns cutting edges of deterritorialization. Absolute deterritorialization implies a deterritorializing element and a deterritorialized element, one of which in each case is allocated to expression, the other to content, or vice versa, but always in such a way as to convey a relative distinction between the two. Thus, both content and expression are necessarily affected by continuous variation, but it still assigns them two dissymmetrical roles as elements of a single becoming, or as quanta of a single flow. That is why it is impossible to define a continuous variation that would not take in both the content and the expression, rendering them indiscernible, while simultaneously proceeding by one or the other, determining the two mobile and relative poles of that which has become indiscernible. For this reason, one must define both traits or intensities of content and traits or tensors of expression. Indefinite article, proper name, infinitive, and date, which take turns leading one another across the plane of consistency. Unformed matter, the phylum, is not dead, brute, homogeneous matter, but a matter movement bearing singularities or hexaities, qualities, and even operations, itinerant technological lineages. And the non-formal function, the diagram, is not an inexpressive meta-language lacking a syntax, but an expressivity movement always bearing a foreign tongue within each language, and non-linguistic categories within language as a whole, nomad poetic lineages. One writes, then, on the same level as the real of an unformed matter, at the same time as that matter traverses and extends all of non-formal language. A becoming animal like Kafka's mouse, Hofmannsthal's rats, Moritz's calves. A revolutionary machine all the more abstract for being real. A regime that no longer operates by the signifier or the subjective.